Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In this episode, we will talk about commercial applications of electrolysis. Electrolysis is used in the manufacture of many important chemicals and in numerous processes for purification and electroplating of metals. Let's look at some examples. The first example, it is the manufacture of sodium. Sodium metal is produced commercially down the cell by electrolysis of a molten mixture of sodium chloride and calcium chloride. The presence of calcium chlorides allows the cell to operate at lower temperature because the melting point, this mixture of sodium chloride and the calcium chloride mixture, is about 580 degrees centigrade, while the melting point of pure sodium chloride is equal 801 degrees centigrade. The liquid sodium produced at the cylindrical steel cathode is less dense than the molten salt and thus floats to the top part of the cell, where it is drawn off into a suitable container. Chlorine gas forms at the graphite anode, which is separated from the cathode by an iron screen to keep the highly reactive sodium and the chlorine away from each other. Because the Downs process requires a high current, typically in the range from 25,000 to 40,000 ampere, plants for producing sodium are located near sources of inexpensive hydroelectric power. The second example about electrolysis or commercial applications of electrolysis is manufacture of chlorine and sodium hydroxide. Production of chlorine and sodium hydroxide by electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride is the basis for the chloroalkali industry, a business that generates annual sales of approximately $4 billion in the United States. Chlorine is used in water and sewage treatment as a bleaching agent, in manufacturing of paper, and in the manufacture of plastics such as polyvinyl chloride (PVC). While sodium hydroxide is employed in making paper, textiles, soaps, and detergent. This cell shows the essential feature of a membrane cell for commercial production of chlorine and sodium hydroxide. As you can see, a saturated aqueous solution of sodium chloride, which is called the brine, flows into the anode compartment, where chloride is oxidized to chlorine gas, and the water enters the cathode compartment, where it is converted to hydrogen gas and OH- ions. Between the anode and cathode compartment is a special polymer membrane that is permeable to cations, but not to anions or water. This membrane between the anode and the cathode compartment is a special polymer membrane that is permeable to cations but not to anions or water. The membrane keeps the chlorine and hydroxide ions apart but allows a current of sodium ions to flow into the cathode compartment, thus carrying the current in the solution and maintaining electrical neutrality in both compartments. The sodium ions and the hydroxide ions flow out of the cathode compartment as an aqueous sodium hydroxide solution. It is created from a membrane cell for electrolytic production of chlorine and sodium hydroxide. A chlorine ion is oxidized to chlorine gas at the anode, and water is converted to hydrogen gas and OH ions at the cathode. Sodium ions move from the anode compartment to the cathode compartment through a cation permeable membrane and then flow out of the cell as an aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide. The third commercial application of electrolysis is the manufacture of aluminum. Although aluminum is the third most abundant element in the Earth's crust at about 8.23% of mass, it remained a rare and expensive metal until 1886, when a 22-year-old American Charles Martin Hall and a 23-year-old Frenchman Paul Herlot independently devised a practical process for the electrolytic production of aluminum. The whole Herlot process involves electrolysis of a molten mixture of aluminum oxide Al2O3 and cryolite Na3AlF6 at about 1000 degrees centigrade in a cell with a graphite electrode. Electrolysis of pure aluminum oxide is impractical because it melts at a very high temperature at 2045 degrees centigrade. And the electrolysis of aqueous aluminum ion solution is not feasible because water is reduced in preference to aluminum ions. Thus, the use of cryolite as a solvent for aluminum oxide is the key to the success of the whole Herlot process. The electrode reactions are still not fully understood, but they probably involve complex anions formed by the reaction of aluminum oxide and the cryolite. The complex anions are reduced at the cathode to molten aluminum metal and are oxidized at the anode to oxygen gas, which reacts with the graphite anodes to give carbon dioxide gas. As a result, the anodes are chewed up rapidly and they must be replaced frequently. The cell operates at a low voltage, about 5 to 6 volt, but with very high currents, up to 250,000 ampere. Because 1 mole of electrons produces only 9 grams of aluminum, electrolytic production of aluminum is the largest single consumer of electricity in the United States, making recycling of aluminum products highly desirable. As with the manufacture of sodium, aluminum production generally takes place near hydroelectric plants. Another commercial application for electrolysis is electro refining and electroplate. The purification of a metal by means of electrolysis is called electro refining. For example, impure copper obtained from ores is converted to pure copper in an electrolytic cell that has impure copper as the anode and the pure copper as the cathode. The electrolyte is an aqueous solution of copper sulfate. As the impure copper anode, copper is oxidized along with more easily oxidized metallic impurities such as zinc and iron. Less easily oxidized impurities such as silver, gold, and platinum fall to the bottom of the cell as anode mud, which is reprocessed to recover the precious metal. As the pure copper cathode, copper ions are reduced to pure copper metal, but the less easily reduced metal ions like zinc ions, ferrous ions, and so forth remain in the solution. So at the anode, the metal is oxidized to metal ions plus electrons, while at the cathode, only copper ions will reduce to copper metal to the pure copper metal. Thus, the net cell reaction simply transfers the copper metal from the impure anode to the pure cathode, and the copper obtained by this process is 99.95% pure. Closely related to electro-refining is electroplating, the coating of one metal on the surface of another using electrolysis. For example, steel motorcycle parts are often plated with chromium to protect them from corrosion, and silver plating is commonly used to make items of fine table surface. The object to be plated is carefully cleaned and then set up as the cathode of an electrolytic cell that contains a solution of ions of the metal to be deposited. This is the end of this episode, and in the next episode, we'll discuss the quantitative aspects of electrolysis. Thank you and see you in the next episode.